Ladies and gentlemen, you have just dialed into the center of the Partay universe.
Yes, that is correct. It's red hot and ready, and today we're doing poultry proctology. Well, that shouldn't be giving him very much more trouble in the very near future.
And I'm gonna be helping you boys get into trouble in the backyard. That's right, we are gonna be building a backyard bar and upping your party potential.
That's not very responsible.
To the grill.
Okay, guys, this show, it's all about the beer. We're gonna do something a little bit different as well. We're gonna take our director, we're gonna mate him with a large elk. We're gonna take him outside, cover him in chocolate sauce, and beat him with a sledgehammer and see if he can fly. Not really. Cracker? Set me up. Okay, today's recipe involves the stuffing of a chicken, as I said. This particular chicken. What we want to do before we actually put our beer can into it, is we want to remove any sundry items that may have fallen loose during the processing and packaging of this fowl. Well done.
Yeah.
Cerveza.
Bottom feeders rule. So I'm gonna make you some roasted peanuts, right? Spiced roasted peanuts. This is the easiest thing in the world. If you can't do this, turn the TV off, walk outside, slap yourself in the head, come back in, turn the women's network on, okay?
What are you, making yourself into a girl?
Why did he accuse you of being a girl? Is there something going on, Cracker, that you haven't told us?
It's not something I'd like to get into.
So, we got some brown sugar. That's about a half a cup. We got some cinnamon, about a tablespoon, okay? We got some cloves, which is about a tablespoon, just under cloves. But we're gonna grind them up here. So. Okay, that should be good. Look at that. There we are. Okay, we wanna figure out a way that we can make these spices stick to the nuts, right? I'm gonna use some egg whites. We're gonna whip them up here, beat them to death. In a copper bowl. We use a copper bowl because copper reacts with the protein, the egg whites, and it makes it rise a lot faster, okay? This is a very simple technique. Put these in the bowl, and you beat them. Holding your whisk like so. And just incorporate a bunch of air into it, right? Sort of like what this straw does to the beer on my head. Incorporates way too much air into it. Okay, we got 2.5 egg whites in here, right? Go between 2 or 3 egg whites, depending upon the size of the egg. And we have 4 cups of peanuts here. When we're beating these, we're gonna beat these into what we call soft peaks, right? There are no peaks there. It's way too soft. Okay, we're almost there. You got that, Dean?
Right.
Soft peaks. Isn't that what your wife calls you?
Oh!
Let's just dump our peanuts and spice straight into the bowl here. Give a little toss, okay? Mm. This smells fantastic, man. This is gonna be great. Okay. That's about ready. I'm gonna throw this on a nonstick pan. Like so. That's good enough. And spread it out evenly, okay? So these puppies can dry on the grill. Okay, one layer of peanuts, right? You up front, sit down. Okay, I'm gonna take this out to the grill, and when they're ready, I'm gonna come back in. We're gonna stuff a chicken.
If I know our audience, you guys are classy and handy. So the next time you have your crowd over for food and drinks, why not have something around to show the ladies that you're classy and show the guys that you still know what you're doing in the garage? Having a backyard bar that's easy to take apart and assemble at a moment's notice is really handy to have around the barbecue season. You can just set it up in the backyard and slap some booze on there and everybody can help themselves. So today I'm gonna challenge Miles to make a backyard bar out of all the stuff he's got around his yard.
It's all about the meat.
Okay, guys, before we stuff our chicken, what I want to do is I want to make a little bit of something for dessert, okay? We're having beer-dressed fruit, but beer fig-dressed fruit, okay?
I knew it looked familiar.
We got some dried figs, but they're not figs, they're dates, okay? That's where I tripped you up, okay? Follow me now, follow me. Okay, we're going to put some cider in there, and we're going to put half a beer in there. This is going to soak for the remainder of the afternoon. There we are, half a beer. Let this soak. They're going to break up these dried figs. What are they? Dates. They're going to absorb all this nice moisture from the alcoholic cider and the beer. It's going to taste great over our fruit a little later on. Okay. Here's our chicken. Hi, I'm a chicken. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to make a spice rub for this before we get on the grill. Okay. This is just going to season the outside of it. Since we're doing sort of a grill roasting technique, it's going to make a nice sort of spicy, crusty exterior. Okay. This is easy as pie, man. Got a bowl, got some spices, got some garlic powder. That's about 2 tablespoons, okay? A tablespoon and a half, roughly, okay? Got some celery seeds. Great, tablespoon of that. We got some chili powder. This is like North American chili powder, chili spice.
Don't forget to show Dean.
Hey Dean, that's where it used to be, okay? We got a bunch of paprika, about 3 tablespoons, okay? Dean. Oh, we got some onion powder as well. That's 1.5 tablespoons. And we got some brown sugar. That's 1/4 cup right there. Okay, straight in. A little bit of salt. That's about 2 tablespoons. Mix it around. Okay, what we need to do, we need to reserve a couple tablespoons of this because this is going to be part of our basting sauce, okay? So 1.5, 2. That's about 2 tablespoons right there. You got that?
Yeah, yeah.
No problem. Okay, let's coat our bird, okay?
You're such a stud.
In the spice rub, that is. Just like that. Rub it straight into the skin. This is gonna be really tasty, right? Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, baby. I never made a plate like you before. Ooh. Yeah, bro. Okay, boy, he sort of got it in hand, didn't he?
No, fits right in, I think.
Thank God we're here to control things. Okay, this guy's ready to rock. What we got here is 1/2 can of beer. What we got here is the remainder of our spice. Let's just try to funnel this in. Doesn't matter if it's messy. It's going up a chicken's butt, right? It's all right. We're trained professionals. We can deal with this. Let's take our chicken. There we are. At least he had his last request, right? There we are. Oh. Oh, yeah. He set his legs out like his grandpa sitting on the porch. Tuck his wings back, right? Dislocate the shoulders. Just sort of tuck them back there. Okay? There we are. Look at that. Isn't that nice?
People are crazy.
Okay, check that out for a Christmas postcard, guys. Okay, look, when we come back, we're taking our beer butt chicken out to the barbecue. That's right, you saw it first. Here, stay tuned for more carnage.
We've got Miles making our backyard bar here. What do we got, Miles?
Well, these are some ABS pipes. You can pick these up pretty much any hardware store, very cheap.
Yeah?
These are 1.5-inch pipes. If you want it a little sturdier, you can use a 2-inch pipe.
Exactly, it's disgusting.
You're going to have to set your own length depending on what you want to use as a bar top. You're going to need 8 T-joints and 4 elbow joints, 90-degree elbow joints. And
make sure they're all 1.5.
Yeah, because they won't fit otherwise.
There's nothing worse when it doesn't fit.
About 2 inches about the right length of plastic to fit in between the joints so that it works out well.
Now that's power.
It goes through that like butter, doesn't it?
Are you gonna blow the end?
Am I gonna? I think I should leave that to you.
There's nothing worse when it doesn't fit.
What? Now we got your special ABS glue. And this stuff is on the plastic. It dissolves the plastic and it actually mixes together so you've got basically one piece of plastic when it's done.
Ooh,
brush this stuff around the inside of the joint. We'll do both sides here. and around the outside of the plastic and just work that inside. Just give it a little twist. Very easy. It doesn't take very long to set up. I wouldn't put a lot of weight on it for at least a half an hour. Your measurements don't have to be really 100% exact because it's pipe, it's plastic, it's flexible, so it'll kind of forgive you a little bit. And just turn that in here, and we'll set that next to there so we make sure we've got a left-handed one instead of a right-handed one. And sight it down the end to try and get it at 90 degrees. So, that's that piece. Same idea. Glue on the inside. And on both ends of my extremely large pipe.
I gotta get my hands on some of those.
Don't do this in an enclosed space because you will find yourself passed out and glued to something.
Yeah, what are you looking at?
Again, just try and make sure it's square. Again, it does not have to be perfect because this pipe will bend. It's pretty forgiving. Now, next thing I'm putting in here are the long pieces for the run of the table.
Do you want me to hold this for you?
Yeah, please, thank you. Again, more glue.
I'll hold it and you lube it up.
Oh my God, how embarrassing.
Okay, all right.
All right, boys, we've got our three main assembled pieces, and when we come back, we're gonna top it up and show you just how cool a backyard bar can be.
Ready.
All right, we're ready to slap this baby together. Let's go, Miles.
All right, if you can hold that one up for me. This goes together real easy now that we've got this together. And
it goes in three easy steps.
You don't actually have to glue these other joints because it will hold itself together like this. But if you want it to be really permanent, you could glue these last joints.
Or you can pay me a lot and I'll come home and hold it for you.
Yeah. All right,
this is
your basic frame for the backyard bar. And you can put whatever you want on top of here, but what we've got is a grungy old piece of plexiglass that was laying in the garage. And if you would be so kind as to grab the other end of that,
sure.
Melissa.
Now, Miles, are we just gonna slap this up on top, or are we gonna hold it down with anything?
No, it can just sit there. I mean, you could wire it down if you really felt anal about it.
No, don't push it in.
I wasn't gonna push it in, I was gonna grab it for you.
But it's not really necessary. That's it.
All right, our backyard bar is finito, and Miles and I are ready to party. He's a pretty creative guy, so he added some lights on in the front. You can do that yourself if you go that far. And we've added some tiki lights, and I think Miles have added the little rose for a little bit of his romantic side.
I was hoping to get some.
So why don't you slap one of these babies together for your next family wedding? Because when your drunk Uncle Frank falls through it, at least you haven't invested that much money.
Peanuts, peanuts, get your fresh peanuts. And free peanuts for everybody. Peanuts for everybody. That's right, we made peanuts on the grill. Have you heard anything so ill? Look, we had indirect cooking over here. That means that we shut off half of the burner, right? We closed it down like an oven. It was 350 degrees. We let these suckers sit in there for about 25, 30 minutes. We busted them up. These are great, man. I love peanuts, man. Peanuts, peanuts, get your fresh peanuts. Okay. We gotta check these out, guys. These are amazing. One thing you gotta know about this, though, is that if there isn't enough salt on these, it's not gonna create the desire. It's not gonna create the desire to drink more beer. So you have to have plenty of salt on these puppies, okay? Mmm. Okay, we got our beer butt chicken over here. We're gonna throw him right on the grill. We're gonna put him in that indirect area of cooking I was telling you about, right? We've shut down this side of the grill. Boom. Just set a spell. Slide him back far enough so when we close this down, the lid's not gonna topple him over, right? See, we left half the beer inside of this can, so this is gonna baste up through the cavity of this bird, right? Nice juicy ass on this thing, okay?
Beautiful.
Close it down. Look for 350 degrees. This is gonna come up in a few minutes. It should be 350, 375 for 1 hour, okay? 1 hour only. Take it out, shove a meat thermometer in it, and if it's the right temperature, which should be around roughly 150, 160, okay, then you can yank it out and let it rest. But not until then, okay? Remember, when? 160 degrees.
That's right.
So that's about 150, 160 degrees. It'll be fine, okay? We're gonna let it rest. Juices are all gonna come out nice and right, okay? Look, what do we got here? Got some corn, right? We're gonna barbecue this stuff up. But I'm gonna show you a really cool way to do this. We're gonna pull back the husks, right? Do one. Do two. You want to try to wipe away any silk that's on here, right? That's this stuff here. Take both sides of the husk, and we're going to tie just a simple half knot here, right? Tuck it through. Pull it tight. And pull it down. Voila. We got a barbecue and handle on these things.
I got it.
Let's grease these babies up. Let's get them on the grill in the indirect heat as well. These are going to roast up really slowly. Just putting a little oil on them to start, but later on we got an interesting basil butter we're gonna put on these babies, okay? What's up? Hello. Straight in here. We're gonna leave the handle sticking out of the barbecue just a little bit, okay? That way the handle's gonna stay moist, and more importantly, they're not gonna be hot when you grab them, okay? So shut this down. Perfect. Okay, guys, what's a little corn without a lot of butter, okay? What I'm gonna show you here is a very simple way to dress your corn up. If you're into dressing corn up, you got a real problem, man.
Well, they didn't ask me, but actually...
I guess that means I have one as well, but that's okay. We're not going to talk about that. I have plenty of therapy time left. They've only punched my ticket twice. This is basil. Quarter cup of basil mixed into about a half cup of butter. And we're going to baste our corn a little while when I see fit.
I agree.
We're going to make a beer dressing, a beer cream cheese dressing for some fruit that we're going to skewer up in just a few minutes, okay? But it's best to have the dressings done before the undressing begins, okay? Whatever the hell that meant.
Drop your pants.
Into the bowl, okay? That's about a half a pound of cream cheese. We got just a little less than half a beer. Now I just realized that's a really bad idea because it's going to make a big mess, but hey, who's cleaning up anyway?
Woman's work is never done, huh?
Okay, we're gonna process for a few seconds here. Let's stop it. Check out our process, so to speak. Look in here. Nice and smooth, right? Okay, to this, we're gonna add a little bit of honey. That's just under half a cup, okay? Dumping that straight in. Because this is dessert, man. We need it sweet, right? Some cinnamon. And half a teaspoon of almond extract. Boom, in the processor. Slap the lid back on it, click it in place. And that's it. That stuff tastes great. That's gonna be fantastic. You're gonna drizzle it all over whatever you want, you know? In this case, it's fruit, but once the cameras go off, it could be anything.
Back off, the sour's mine!
Okay, we're cutting our fruit up into skewer-sized pieces. We don't really need to go into too much depth there. It's pretty obvious, isn't it? Okay? So when I come back, it's beer butt chicken and we're having some more peanuts. Okay, check you then. You got a peanut in your lunch. Okay, guys, we are back. We are back, and check this out. Our beer butt chicken is getting nice and brown. It is almost ready. The corn is browning up too. Remember that butter I made? Well, I'm going to show you what to do with this now, right? Last time my girlfriend did this, she disappeared for 3 days. I don't know. She said she was busy. Corn tasted some good though.
I knew it looked familiar.
Okay, we got our fruit skewers here, right? Fruit kebabs, fruit brochette for those in the know. We're just going to get them down. We're going to get down with them. And we're gonna put a little bit of oil on them, throw them onto the hot spot in the grill. We're still cooking indirect on the other side, right? Had we not been cooking indirect, well, this would be a big bloody black mass, right? Throw that down. And I'm just gonna take this opportunity to come over here and finger my date.
Mm. Do you wanna be alone with your date?
I know, there's plenty for two.
You know what, I know John's all downhill all the time, especially with the beer can hat, but if you want to take it a little more cleaner, you can season your chicken with either cola or root beer. It doesn't always have to be beer up the hole.
Guys, you can season your date with cola and root beer as well, and that's equally as fun, okay? Okay, check this out, Don. What we got here is, well, perhaps you want to do this.
Don's always got the seasoned sauce, doesn't he?
Why don't you grease up those cobs?
Get it slippy and slathery and melting butter. Yum.
Gonna keep an eye on these. We got our fruit kebabs happening over here. We're gonna put them straight on the plate. And once we're on the plate, we're gonna finger our date. Okay. Slide a little date on top of that. That looks great. That's gonna be really tasty.
I like lots of butter because there's no other way to eat a cob of corn than with butter slipping and dripping out of your mouth. You are so, so, so dirty.
I liked it.
Okay, and we're just going to drip a little bit of this cream cheese sauce over. This will probably look, this is probably more suited to the cob, would
so
you say?
It's cream cheese sauce?
This is a cream cheese and beer sauce. Oh. Everything's about beer today, right. You know?
I was going to say, John, cream cheese sauce, that sounds great. But obviously he had to add some beer in there. Wouldn't be manly enough now, would it?
Creamy, yes, but I like it too.
Well, don't look at me like that. It is.
Manly, but damn good.
Okay. You know what? Help me here. I'm going to have to lift off our beer butt chicken. We prepared a plate for it.
Poor, poor thing. The things he does to animals on this show.
I find it's good to just grab the neck and slide it up into the cavity. Straight on the plate. Look at that.
And what are these nasty things that are our garnishes today? That's disgusting.
Actually, what it is, it's a fig. Let me try, Robert, here, try that out.
I've never seen the old crusty ones.
There we are. Well, now you've seen an old crusty one eating an old
Robert,
crusty one.
Oh.
How about that?
I'm red hot and ruined.
We got the cobs. There we are. There we are. This is a meal fit for a beer-drinking king.
Nothing but class.
That's because we're red hot and ready, gentlemen.
The home of Smoky Good Eats.